on club activities? How many districts can't find lieutenant governors or have to rely on the same old to fill district chair positions? The ultimate answer lies at the club level. There are clubs out there that run successful operations and they don't experience these taxing situations. At this convention, we invited a select group of representatives from some of the best clubs this organization has to offer. This past Wednesday, these representatives linked arms and discussed today's challenges and strategies. They brought to the table success stories, plans, and actions that will allow Optimist International to formulate a white paper on best practices. These clubs are the leaders in their communities, their districts, and Optimist International. They are Optimists doing what all Optimists do with one difference. They are the most successful, and they represent clubs within their communities that people want to be involved with. Let me restate that. They have developed a status within their community that caring adults want to be a part of. I believe that internal structures of all clubs are similar: boards of directors, committees, and activities to serve the community. I also believe that the ultimate goal of every club is to do the best that they can. Most clubs struggle in the area of capturing and holding the interest of their members. We live in a world where our members' time is constantly competed for. Many members are reluctant to make long-term commitments, or they wait until the very last minute to say, "I'll be there." Like it or not, a level of self-interest must be satisfied. The old adage of "what's in it for me" really takes precedence. If what we offer is higher on their priority list, we stand a better chance of getting their involvement. With so many social options available to our members, we have to ask the hard questions. Is the kind of atmosphere we offer conducive to what our members are looking for? Are our members being expected to attend a club meeting that is only business, knowing that they don't sit on the board, they don't have a vote in the decision-making process? Let me ask you this. In your spare time, if you had an opportunity to be with your grandchildren, or go golfing, or shopping, or sitting through a meeting that was only business, where would you want to be? We must promote an inviting social aspect within our clubs. We need to become creative, respectful, and attractive to our members. If our club meetings are not attractive, if our leadership doesn't make the club environment fun, we will continue to move farther down our members' priority list. We have to take a good look at ourselves and determine what our members want. Let's get back to having social fun, but remember, what might be fun for me might not be fun for everyone. Find that magic recipe. I'm convinced that many of our problems could be resolved by the enthusiasm of new members. There are some interesting facts that the organization has learned over the years. It is proven that 7% of our membership does all the recruiting. This is consistent from year to year. We also will lose 20% of our membership in our clubs every year, leaving fewer and fewer to provide the service we offer. If only 7% do the recruiting, the question remains, how do we get the other 93% more involved in making our organization stronger? Membership recruitment suffers because most clubs don't have a working recruitment plan. It is my hope that we can inspire new member recruitment by everyone focusing on an organizational-wide recruitment all at the same time. In 2013-14, we will have an incentive to promote membership growth every quarter in every region. Once every quarter, we will draw 8 club names, one from each region. To qualify, the club must have been successful in recruiting a minimum of 3 new members in the previous quarter. Those 8 clubs will receive a $250 grant to apply towards a youth activity. Here's how it will work. Each club will be encouraged to utilize their 7% recruiting membership as their club's membership committee. The first month of every quarter, October, January, April, and July, we will be declared prospect months. I'm asking each club to focus on establishing a board-approved potential membership list during that month. Involve all members of your club by having everyone offer up names of potential members. Use the 7%ers as your club's membership committee and charge them to make contact with the prospects in the second month of the quarter. During the third week of each second month of every quarter, I'm asking that every club do their hands-on recruiting. Hold your NOW programs, do your door knocking, talk face-to-face. But when it's done, go online and register those new members during that third week. All of us then can go on and watch our membership grow. Do this at a minimum of 3 members and your club name will be included in the quarterly draw. Most importantly, your club will have the enthusiasm and energy that comes with new members. Here's the key, the key here is to use the third month of every quarter to give those new members an opportunity to show you what they can do. Give them a job. History has shown us that ever since the mid-1940s, neither districts or Optimist International would have shown any positive growth if it wasn't for the results of new club building. What this means is that for a district to be successful, for a district to flourish, there must be success in new club building. Attempts to retain membership growth in our existing clubs as your only salvation will not be successful. Almost 70 years of tracking have proved this point. As we have become a smaller organization in the last 20 years, there has been a steady decline in the district's ability to encourage activity in new club building. This has resulted in fewer experienced builders available to undertake the potential sites. In 2013 and 14, we will be assisting districts by providing additional experienced personnel to aid their new club building efforts. All districts will be asked to target and start a new club project. And at the request of the district governor, Optimist International will assist by sending an experienced builder into the district. This person will be there to aid the district in the hopes that it will put a successful conclusion to their new club building activity. I'm asking that each district not just appoint a district new club building chair, but that each governor establish an NCB team. This team will build and teach others in the field how to be successful in the efforts of building new clubs. As an organization, we have no choice. If you believe, as I do, that what we do under the name of optimism is vital to our communities and the children we serve, then we must rally behind new club building. There is no other option. We can't allow tomorrow's children not to find hope and positive vision. We must be there and we must come together to make it happen. Otherwise, in the words of my father, we are only cheating ourselves. Lastly, I would like to share with each of you one new concept of affordable training. I told you how I believe that we have to start correcting our problems at the club level. In the second and third quarters of the 2013-14 year, we will be convening 16 Optimist Leadership Summits. These summits will be one-day training opportunities targeted at our club's leadership. The sites will not be located to relate to specific regions, but are targeted so that that interested optimists from anywhere in the organization can drive to a site, attend the training, enjoy a lunch, and return home again all on the same day. We are focused on the second and third quarters because we feel that it is the perfect time for club leaders to reassess their goals, to identify their problems, and discover the answers to redirect their clubs to a finish in a positive year. These Optimist Leadership Summits will provide the very best of results gathered on the best practices of this year's white paper. It will bring to the training the very best trainers this organization has to offer. It will be for those Optimist leaders wanting to make a difference in their clubs, and it will be an opportunity to bring us together with one goal in mind: to bring out the best in kids. The MO year can be successful, but we must take a serious look at ourselves. We are either a group of individual isolations, or we are a collective force to be reckoned with. I'm humbled to have been chosen to serve. I will do all that I can not to let you down. I only ask that you do all that you can not to let the kids down. Help me make tomorrow a better day. Thank you and merci.
As everybody knows, Ron is a jeweler, and I told him, Ron, what you should do is, we see a lot of body punctures right now, you know, put diamonds on. I said, you put one here, that way your glasses wouldn't fall off every time. Thank you, Ron. I'm confident that our organization is in very good hands next year. Just a few minutes ago, you met the two newly elected members to the board who will begin their term on October 1st. That means two present members of the board will finish their three-year term on September 30th. We would like to thank them for their service to the organization. Please welcome Chris Jernigan and Marlene, and Fatima Platter and her escort. In Montreal, when we say escort, doesn't mean the same thing. if we could get this. The teleprompter seemed to have jammed somewhere. They've been astounding board members who have always looked out for the interests of our clubs, as well as the organization as a whole. To mark their retirement, I would like to present each one of them a special hand-lettered proclamation from the Board of Directors of Optimist International on behalf of all of our Optimist clubs and their members. We extend our heartfelt thanks for your service to the organization. Since October 1st, 2010. Maybe I'm getting tired, I don't know. Since October 1st, 2010, and you will be completing your mandate as of September 30th, 2013.
She learned it took her 2 years.
By the way, Chris came down on a motorcycle.
Not sure how I'm going to get this home, but thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's also another individual who will be retiring from our board as of September 30th. I would like us to recognize our immediate past president, Mr. Jack Creswell, and Sue. We always have to do this on stage, right?
Jealous.
I'm jealous. Jack and Sue, it's an honor for me as president of Optimist International to present to you this resolution from the other members of the 2012-2013 Board of Directors. Before I make this presentation, let me read what is inscribed on it. This is going to be interesting. A tribute to Jack Creswell, who has served as a member of the Board of Directors of Optimist International for 4 years. Whereas during these years, in the exercise of his sound and constructive judgment, he has greatly contributed to the function, decisions, and innovations of the Board of Directors. And whereas he has served in the most manner in many capacities within our organization, including as a club member, a president of the Optimist Club of Daniel Boone, Douglasville, Pennsylvania, governor of Pennsylvania Upper Delaware District, member and chair of international committees, vice president of Optimist International, international board member, president-elect, and 2011-2012 president of Optimist International. And whereas his efforts in furthering the high ideals and objectives of Optimist, you got these long words, international, I have been a constant source of inspiration for those who have been privileged to associate with him, and whereas his leadership and his devotion have greatly contributed to the progress and achievements of Optimist International. Therefore, be it resolved that we, the members of the 2012-2013 Board of Directors of Optimist International, on behalf of all individual Optimists present, give you this scroll as a permanent record of our gratitude. And I can also say, Jack has become a very good friend in the past 2 years. Thank you, Jack.
Mon ami.
Congratulations.
Merci.
Now I kiss them. I do the kissing.
Hey, don't do that. I gotta get your wife up here.
You've got to reduce the length of the words. This is stupid. Man.
Which page of these do you want me to do?
Those are notes.
Mesdames et messieurs.
And whatever.
No, forget that. President J.C., I would like to take the opportunity of being here on the stage to ask Marcel to join you and Susan and I at this time.
I'm not a jealous person.
Not from a little guy. President J.C. and Marcel, I know that the past 9 months have been exciting and rewarding, as Sue and I know, also exhausting. But I know you are looking forward to the last quarter of this year and all of the achievements that your team has yet to produce. Both of you have represented the organization extremely well, and all of us appreciate everything you have done and will do in the future. On behalf of everyone in the organization, as a small token of our appreciation.
Do you need help? Maybe it's the podium.
He got the disease.
It's the podium.
God, I almost made it to the end. As a small token of our appreciation, I would like to present to you, JC, as a Citizens Echo Drive Watch, a very special gift.
If you can find it. There it is.
That's my water.
Yeah, don't look for it. It's right there. Jack, stop it. It's right here.
Oh, well, honey, I'm just used to you finding these things.
Yeah.
JC.
Yes.
This beautiful watch.
What time is it?
It's in French.
Thank
it's
you.
It's just a token of our esteem and our regard and our love for you and your lovely wife. There is no proclamation, there are no words that I could come up with that could ever display or to share with you how deeply we love you and appreciate it. At this time, I have great pleasure and humility to present this watch to you, and you better not be late to another doggone meeting.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Wait a minute. Flowers
from our Susan. And to you, Marcel, for all of your support and work on behalf of the organization, please accept this gift with our heartfelt thanks from the organization.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, fellow optimists and friends, it's a wonderful experience to stand here. My time is done. My boat is about to push off from the island. Some of you I may never see again, but you will always be in my heart. We will always know that together we shared the journey to bring out the best in youth. Thank you so very much. On behalf of Susan and I, we love you all.
I just want to take a second in my name and Marcel's name to thank you for the gift. Marcel said it yesterday, it isn't necessary. What you do for the children of the world is the best gift we could have. If you would have been at the last meeting where we had a discussion on Commit to Kids, just rewind, you'll see what I said there. The children of today are the future of tomorrow. Thank you.
And now let's go back 12 months to the close of last year's convention.
Magic spark that lights the fire of our imagination. And since the dawn of man, the strength of just I can has brought together people of all nations. There's nothing ordinary in the living of each day. There's a special part every one of us will play. Feel the flame forever burn, teaching lessons we must learn to bring us closer to the power of the dream. As the world gives us its best to stand apart from all the rest, it is the power brings us here. Your mind will take you far. The rest is just your heart. You'll find your fate is all your own creation. And they bring the gift of hope and inspiration. Feel the flame forever burn, teaching lessons we must learn to bring us closer to the power of the dream. The world unites in hope and peace. We pray that it will always be. It is the power of the dream that brings. Child and man, it's the moment that you think you can't, you'll discover that you yeah.
Once again, please welcome the president of Optimist International, J.C. Saint-Ange.
Good afternoon. Every time I watch that video, it does something. When I sat down a couple of weeks ago because staff were bugging my butt to get a speech in or get my final remarks in, I figured, why don't I go back to where we came in? We came in last year showing a video of 52 children across the world with one intention, to take control of why and what do we do. This PowerPoint, for me, is very important. We try as an organization to do our very best to bring out the best in kids. And in this day and age, we need to do it for the future. Everything we do is important in the life of a child. Within our different communities, we're all different. We do things differently, but we have one specific goal, is how can I help a child somewhere in the world? Almost a year ago, I stood in front of you, in front of the delegates in Milwaukee, and communicated with all of you that I would do my best with my team to help our organization grow, but with your help. This is not my organization. This is not his organization. This is our organization. We all made the commitment, and I must say, up to now, we're achieving our goals. But it's never too late to do better. It's never too late to do more. And we still have close to 3 months to carry out our dream, our objectives, to try and fulfill the mandate. Now we need to be ready for the fourth quarter. Those who remember, I use the vision of a football team. I know I'm the size of a mid linebacker, but I can't run. The song, The Power of the Dream, was I had a dream in 1972. That was broken because of a broken shoulder. But I still have the dream for 2012, 2013, and the future to get our organization back on track, to have more people serving more kids, and to be present in communities where we don't have people. But when you review it, this should not be, JC's year, Ron's year, Jack's year. It should be our year. We are loaned as your presidents or vice president or governor for 1 year. In our case, I thought it was 1 year, then I found it was eight. But we're loaned. Our club has trust in us. Our district has trust in us. And the delegates that come to a convention also trust us, and they elect us. But at the base, what are we? What are we at the base? I'm a member, and a very proud member, of a club. And I think that my club does awesome things, and I'm convinced that you have the same thought about your club. It should be a continuity of our commitment in helping bring out the best in kids. Recently, I viewed a video that I would like to share with you. Now, this video really gets to me, so if I break up while it's playing, please close the lights. You don't want to see a 250-pound, 60-pound guy break up, okay? It's a story of a little boy who had a dream. He wanted to become a football player. But due to sickness, he had a bad case of cancer. A professional football team brought him under his wing and had him live his dream. I'd like us for now to review the Jack Hoffman story. Let's view it together.
And he's wearing the number 22, guys. It is Jack Hoffman of Team Jack coming out on the field right now in this fourth down and short.
For the red team.
Jack Hoffman has been adopted really by this football team. A young man who has battled brain cancer is on the field right now for the Huskers.
One more snap for Taylor Martinez, too, who will hand it off to Jack.
So Taylor gets the shotgun set, gives it to Jack. Here he goes. He's got blockers out in front.
There he goes.
He's running to midfield. Listen to this crowd as Jack Hoffman, a young man that, as I mentioned, has really been adopted by this football team, just scored a touchdown.
Oh, wow. What a moment.
And both benches empty.
That was a moment right there. Wow. Goosebumps.
You like it? It could be a basketball game, a football game, a baseball game. Could be at anywhere. We get involved with the kids. We try to make them happy. He's happy. This is, I'm going to start singing. This is only one of many examples of things that we are doing for children, helping them live a better life. And we have seen many of these examples during our different visits in your regions. We were impressed with everything you people do. We're impressed with the variety of activities that you have. And I'm not putting down any community because we've seen so many things that my mind gets mixed up. But that's me, I'm getting old. I'm 63 going on 47. We will cherish in our memory our trip to California in December. Even if we left 24 hours late because of a snowstorm, and that's always fun, and we got there and we had 9 days planned, we were there for 8 days, we were able to get 21 visits in. This was mainly due to a person called Jim Oliver. Don't tell him you're coming. He'll make it a point that he gets you busy. We were able to visit the Rainforest Hospital. We were able to visit the youth home that, for me, was awesome. Reminded me when I was a teenager. We visited the Ronald McDonald home. We didn't have any Big Macs, didn't have any, but we saw exactly what this thing was out there for. Jim kept us pretty busy, and we enjoyed every second of it. We came back a little bit exhausted. But we were so happy to have seen what the West Coast does because I had heard of things, but I had never seen them. We visited 8 other regions during the year with PDCs. We saw exactly what the people would do. But the other visit that really got to me here is our visit to Jamaica. They do so much with so little, it is unreal. We had the chance to visit a hospital. Now, you're going to say, what's wrong with this guy? He likes hospitals. No. But I wanted to be able to touch what I could feel in their passion for what they were doing. The volunteers go out and get the children and the family all over the island to bring them into the hospital. The emergency ward is packed like this room. You have children from all ages. Some of them, you wonder why are they there, until you find out why they're there. And then you see the parents, how much they care for that child and what they can do. But then you see Optimist walking around with a smile on their face. You would not believe what this does to a child. Then you walk through the wards. Any grandparents in here? I mean real ones.